Hi guys, this is Asad Siddiqui. I'm the owner and developer at idesignsmart.com. I do small business websites as my freelance projects just to keep my creative side alive. This is going to be a short tutorial on how to customize WordPress websites and what you can do to, if you like a theme and you want to change certain aspects of it, you don't want to hire anybody to do it, this is how you do it. And I'm going to briefly touch upon child themes and what, when you need them and when you don't need them. So I have a sample WordPress install over here. It's just the 2012 most basic theme. I put on an image and some text to go with it. And we are going to customize the theme a little bit. I'll show you examples of what you can do with Google Chrome tools and how you can edit the styles of your site. So basically, all the styles of your website is controlled by something called CSS or cascading style sheets. And you can change cascading style sheets of your site or edit them to give your site a different style. All your cascading style sheets are located under, if you go to appearance and then click on editor, and then there is a, under styles, you will see the style sheet, which is styles.css. So I have it open on my browser here in the editor, and you can look at all the styles that are defined in 2012 theme. Now, one very important thing is if I start modifying this design, like I just changed these 24 pixel to a 10 pixel, it's going to change the style as I want it. But whenever I update the theme and this file gets modified and updated by the author, I'm going to lose my change. So to avoid that, a lot of themes have options for custom CSS or something that they override your CSS file with, and you can define your custom changes there. So you can install a plugin. Let's go ahead and install that. So you can just say add new and just say custom CSS. Search plugins, and the first one that comes up, really I'm not looking for anything fancy, so I'll just go ahead and install that. So once I install that and activate it, it is going to give me an option here called simple custom CSS. The plugin got installed, and under appearance you will see something called custom CSS right here. So you can define your own styles in this file, and you can keep updating your theme as the author comes out with new updates and fix bugs and do whatever. So this is very helpful. You won't need a child theme in this scenario. So only thing you are modifying is the CSS. You don't have to really install any child theme or the files that came with the theme. So now I'm going to give you guys a quick demo of the Chrome developer tools. So I like Google Chrome very much. I think maybe it's not faster, but it's very cleaner, and it gives you an easy way to modify a lot of things on your site. So this site is right now configured to just have a simple homepage with some text and image on there with some more text and a UI, a UL, like a ordered list on an unordered list. And it has a widget bar in the side which displays some basic widgets that are the defaults. So let's see how we can view these widgets in what kind of CSS gets applied to it and change them in the browser. So the first thing we want to do is whatever text you like that you want to style differently. Let's say I wanted all these headings to be somewhat slightly bigger and have some kind of color behind the text. So what I'm going to do is select this text and right click on it and say inspect element. When I say inspect element, a window gets popped out, which is the developer or debugger for Google Chrome. So this is how it sees the HTML and CSS of your website. And you can hover over different elements and it's gonna highlight them on the screen. So you have an idea of exactly what you're looking at. So this tool is actually inspired by Firebug, which is a Firefox plugin. And now Internet Explorer also has a developer tools, but the most best one that I've used Firebug very extensively, but the best one that I like very much is Google Chrome developer tools, because I think it just nails it and does exactly what is needed, not only for CSS, but you can do JavaScript, and it has console that you can use to run scripts and so forth. So if you go back to Elements view, here's the HTML of the page, here is the CSS that's getting applied. And if there is a site out there that you like very much, you can go over to that site and look at how it is styled. For example, I can go to CNN.com. Let's say I like CNN.com very much. So I can just look at how this heading is styled right here. So I can, So I can just select this text right here, right click on it, say inspect element, and it's gonna display all the styles. So basically, I have a special style which is called CNN generic T1 and H4. H4 is heading 4, and it has a certain style to it. All the styles that are getting applied can be seen here. So I can change this from 20 pixel to, let's say, 40 pixel. And you see that it's going to change on the page right there, so you can preview how it's gonna look like. And you can deselect certain elements, so you can remove the padding from it and the background color, different things, font weight, and this guy is changing. So I'm actually changing the search for flight now because I'm in a different CSS class. So you can play around with it, change the colors of it, like from a gray radiant, I'm gonna take it to a red radiant, and change their stop color to something else. So basically the point is you can modify the CSS here and then grab the whole file, that grab the whole CSS, just copy and paste in your custom CSS, and you have the whole style of how this is styled. So going back to my example, let's say I wanted to change, put some background color behind this widget text. So what I'm gonna do, select this, right click it, inspect it, and this is what I'm going to modify. So this right now is styled as, this is the CSS class that's gonna style your element. So if I start designing, so also one important thing that you see is there is also a widget class called widget title that is getting applied. So anything that is grayed out is not getting applied, but if it is a black text, it means that this class is getting applied to that that HTML element. So H3 is applying right now, and higher precedence is the widget title, and the most highest precedent is the widget area with widget and H3. So this is the most advanced rule that you can get. So I can define a background color here. So I can do background. Another nice thing is it has IntelliSense built in, so you can do something and it's gonna give you all the options, attributes that CSS3 is supporting. So you can do background color and colon, and you can pick anything that pretty much. So you see, if I do, for example, violet, it's gonna give the violet color to this CSS, and now I can click on the violet and then make it as I want from this color selection box. So I customized one aspect of how my widget background looks like. Now let's say I want to change the text color to like something else. So I will just say color and colon, and I will pick anything again that I'll just say black. And once I have this box, I can just go ahead and see whatever I like. So maybe I like this orange text, whatever. So I'll make this orange. Now you see all the widget titles are orange. So I styled it in a certain way. Now I have all the CSS that I can grab. So I'm just gonna select this, copy this, and go to my site, and in my custom CSS, Just put the whole thing as it is and say update custom CSS. Remember, whenever we are playing with stuff here, it's not a live update. So we are not really updating our site. We are just testing the style. But once we do this and say update, then we have modified the style of the site. So if I refresh this page, I refresh it, all my styles are there. Okay, so I see how it is looking like. Let's say I want to customize how home is styled here. So I select this, right click, inspect element, and then here is the topmost, all pages titles will be styled like that. So instead of I'm gonna add some more. So font, I will say weight, for example. See how I change the selection, it changes the text over there. So I'll say bold, just for the heck of it. And if I want to do something else with it, like make it underlined or something, I can do text, decoration, and make it underline. Okay, so now all my pages will be styled like that. Titles will be styled like that. So I can grab this CSS class. It always starts with a dot and it has an open parenthesis over there. So you can copy that, go into your custom CSS and just paste it, update it, and refresh your page. And it's as simple as that. And you click on about this, it's gonna be styled the same way. So all your title entries with tag h1 is going to be like that. So this is how you style it. You can style menu elements, you can style headers, you can style text, you can style widgets, whatever you want. Let's say we needed a yellow background where it says no category right now. So right click, inspect element, it's contained inside of a div. So the div is what we are looking for. So this is the whole div. This is the div like that we want to change the background color for. So if I go ahead and say background color, you see all these properties. So it has images and positions and things like that that you can control with CSS. So I will just say yellow. And then I will just select on this box and do whatever pretty much I want. So any area that you want to modify like that, it's gonna be styled a little differently. Anything that has text will have a yellow background. So this was a quick and dirty tutorial on how to modify CSS. You can test it out on any website pretty much. So if I go to UDesign Demo, which is my favorite theme, it happens to be my favorite theme. So if I go to their site, and typically on any demo sites, you will see a lot of styles because they want to demo what they have or what kind of styles you can do. You can play around with the CSS and see what kind of customizations you can do. For example, let's say how this heading would look like if this was some other color, or right now it's this color. Let's change it to this color and how the red looks like. So you have modified the theme a little bit to see how red text is going to look like. If you have any more questions, or if you'd like to talk about any topic on WordPress theme customization, or how to go about child themes, migrate content, or integrate payments with your websites, feel free to email me. My email address is in the description of this video, so is my contact information. And I'll be very happy to answer your questions. Anything in particular about WordPress or web development, I can pretty much answer your question. So I look forward to hearing from you. Leave a comment if you have any suggestion, or if you would like to hear about a certain topic or a technique that I discussed in the video. Thanks very much. Have a good day.